some people would say you are out of your mind crazy. Why do you want to get so close to tornadoes and do this?
Well, I think the things that I do, I plant probes in the paths of tornadoes. And in order to get them correctly in the path, you have to be close. Manchester tornado was a little too close for me. I don't like being that close, but the road network and everything sort of dictated that's where I had to be.
How close was too close?
The tornado was about 100 yards in closing.
How fast do they close on you?
This particular tornado was moving about 15 to 20 miles an hour.
Wow.
Yes. In fact, we can see telephone poles being ripped out of the ground and absorbed into the tornado as I did the first drop.
There is a point where your cameraman says to you, we got to go. And you seem to not be listening. Let's first listen to just a little chunk of what the two of you have to say.
Dan, we don't have time.
Huh?
Don't have time. We don't have time. Seriously.
Yeah, he's not kidding. You don't have time. I mean, you can see the poles being blown out behind. How did you get out of there?
Well, actually, he was saying that. And because he was looking straight at the tornado, I was thinking all logistics. We had a road that went to the north, so I knew that as soon as we turned the corner, we'd be just driving up the north, and the tornado would be following us basically up the road.
Do you get scared when you do this, or are you so focused because you're doing the probes that it's your cameraman who's watching the progress of the tornado that's freaking out,
actually,
and you're sort of focused on something else?
Actually, I'm pretty focused on our safety, certainly, and I'm focused on getting the data and getting in the right spot. You only have one chance to do it, and I want to make sure to be at the right spot.
Yeah, but you know, you got lots of chances to have near misses, and you've had lots of near misses. There was once, though, when you had a direct hit of your probe, and I want to listen to a little bit of the dialogue where you guys were talking about that.
You may not find this probe for days. It's part good. There it is, still there! My God. Guys, our probe's still there.
Describe for me what the probe looks like. How big is it? I mean, obviously you could spot it from the distance a little bit.
The probe is actually 20 inches in diameter by about 6 inches high. And it's painted orange and it weighs about 45 pounds. And I think the whole team was surprised to find the probe there after an F4 tornado went over it. In fact, as you look at the video, you can see that the gravel was scoured all around the probe. And as I lift up the probe, all the gravel was intact under the probe. And that was fantastic.
What kind of information does the probe itself give you?
The probe actually records the barometric pressure drop, which is something that you can calculate the tornado strength or wind speed. And it also records temperature and humidity and lots of other smaller factors.
You've been doing this for 15 years.
I've been chasing storms for 15
100
years.
100 tornadoes, I read. Is that about right, or is that a little low?
You know, I haven't been counting.
After the first 50.
Yeah, I've seen quite a few. The probe deployment is something I've been doing just the last couple of years, but the 15-plus years of storm chasing, I go out and just enjoy the atmosphere and watch tornadoes. It's fantastic.
What do you do when it's not tornado season?
Probably build equipment, anticipate the next season.
You live for tornado season. It's
yes.
Nice to see you.